like it stays like that. We have also another cousin. She lived to be about almost near 90, and her name is Georgie. She lived in a little shack over there in the woods, and she was there. She was here her whole life. She left for a minute, got married for a minute, had three beautiful Indian legal children, came back, had a rainbow tribe, which I don't know where they came from. It's like all different. They just like everything. And they look like, her kids were like everything. I was like, what were you doing? She was pretty wild. But anyway, she was telling me, she was sitting there talking about, I play a banjo for church. And then she was telling me all the ratchet things she was doing and who she was messing with. Yes, she had boyfriends way into her 70s and 80s. She was wild. She lived out there, and she lived out there all that time. And she said, I said, how you living on a plantation? I said, you pay rent? She was like, yeah. I don't have to pay nothing, but I think she paid a utility or something, like, I don't even know. And I was like, I got everything I want. And I was like, dude. I was like, but you know, that's what she felt. She felt like she had everything she wanted. She was just as content as can be. You know, for me. But let me tell you, it's beautiful. The land. You see what we're looking at, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so Georgie's house was along there. It looked the same. Beautiful. I don't know if she realized that. You know, I don't know how she. I guess she did. You know, but it's very beautiful. And as we walk towards here, you see, these gardens are known as like really famous gardens. You know. Beautiful gardens, well manicured. They have people working on it, keeping it right. You know, they have now the garden week every April, right? The house is open, people can walk in. Used to be the tour of plantations. Now it's the tour of historical or southern homes or whatever. Because when it was plantation time, everybody was like, I'm living in the life. And they were enjoying that stuff, but then I guess it became a little inappropriate, so they had to change it. In my opinion, they need to bring that shit back. Just call it what it is. Why are we not saying plantation? Why are we not talking about the history in the right context the way it is? We ain't got to be ashamed of any kind of historical truth. Let's live the historical truth. You don't got to free it up and call it Southern Homes. That's just ridiculous. Call it what it is. If it's plantation tours, let's do a plantation tour. And actually, let's have some real plantation tours. You know, we can actually make it real. There's a thing called dark tourism, where mm-hmm. you actually talk about the dark, deep secrets and everything. Mm-hmm. People will love that. That's real. You know what I'm saying? We need to do the real things and be real about everything. I think the sooner we all start being very honest about the history and start mm-hmm. really stop covering up everything right. and start living it like it really is, the better yes. off we all will be in this country, okay? All these secrets must end. All these lies must end. We must stop it. You know, yes, these people are still in these graves here. They kept these secrets, and maybe they didn't even want. Maybe they didn't even want these secrets to be kept. Right? You don't really know. Because actually, these people in this grave might have been okay with it. You know, if you look in their genealogy, you see people that there's a Negro woman named Grace. She's a Negro. She's buried in there with them. Mm-hmm. There's things that we don't know about. Things that happen without time, you know, throughout time, and things that were acceptable and things that were accepted we don't even know about. And then people cover it up, and people don't talk about it, and it becomes a secret, becomes something that nobody knows about. But it's still there, you know, and we are still family, and we still have connections with each other, you know what I'm saying? So it only makes right for us to do the right thing and, you know, give history its justice. Give the people its justice, be historically correct, and give justice to the history that we live in, you know? This Negro woman buried with the family, her name is Grace, and so I had learned about that like way long ago, probably in like 2000 or something like that. And then, you know, I just kind of...